Today I'm going to be talking about a demonstration called Pepper's Ghost. What is Pepper's Ghost? It's a special effect to initially make a ghost appear on stage. This was thought of around the 19th century, and it was named after John Henry Pepper, who popularized it. That was in 1862. And it's used in plays, concert, amusement parks, and all sorts of applications that even apply to the modern day. This picture to the left here shows the initial use of Pepper's Ghost. So when people would watch plays, a ghostly apparition would appear in front of them, and that was made possible through some basic optical principles that I'll get into. What is the physics of Pepper's Ghost? How does this really work? To understand it, we need to understand two main principles. The first is Fermat's principle, which says that light travels in straight lines and will take the quickest path from point A to point B. Light travels as quick as it can, pretty much. And then the law of reflection states that when a light ray hits a surface, the angle of that ray is going to be equal to that when it gets reflected. This image to the right here shows a diagram of these principles at work, and this actually corresponds to the demo that I'm going to show later. We put an image on some sort of screen, such as a smartphone or a television, and there's a certain image. You can do anything, like here's a pineapple, but you can do the earth or like jellyfish that I'm going to show later. This image, actually, the light travels to the pyramid surface, which is made of plexiglass, and then this light gets reflected and turns into a virtual image. So imagine you're standing in front of a mirror to get ready, and you're looking at yourself. So the image that you're looking at of yourself is what we call a virtual image. So it's not actually really there, but our brain perceives it to be there. So it just looks like a regular image to us. Similarly, when we look straight in through the pyramid, we see that virtual image, which is the pineapple, and we kind of see it floating in the pyramid because our brain perceives that to be actually there. With that, I'm going to go back to the play that I was talking about as I showed this image to the left here previously. I kind of show a little schematic of what's going on. So we have the ghost right here, and we have a lit stage. We need the light to make this possible. A light shines on the ghost, and then the light travels to the glass, again, some sort of plexiglass, because the material has to be reflective, yet you have to see through it because you don't want to see a piece of glass in the middle of your play. It's important that you can see through it, yet it can reflect light. The light travels to this glass and then reflects off the glass and travels to the audience. And then that audience sees that virtual image that I was talking about earlier. And because the light is see-through, you know, they're just seeing the image of the ghost without seeing the actual object of the ghost or the glass. It's a simple yet powerful way to make what you would say maybe holograms, but is Pepper's ghost actually a hologram? Well, the short answer is no. It's in popular culture, people refer to it as a hologram, but actually it just uses simple rules of reflection and transmission of light, whereas a hologram, you actually use laser beams. So you use two laser beams to shine on an object at different angles, and then you have some sort of a holographic film that you record on. And that makes that three-dimensional hologram that you may know from Star Wars. Princess Leia communicates through a hologram. It's a different concept, but the cool thing about Pepper's Ghost, even though it's not quite a hologram, it still gives that illusion of something being there. There are quite a few applications, even in the modern day, of Pepper's Ghost. So people use teleprompters, for example. For a teleprompter, in the case the presidential teleprompter, there's a piece of reflective glass on a stand or a pole, and then this allows the president or whoever speaking to read off the words so they don't have to do it from memory, and they don't break eye contact with the audience because the words are just right there. This is kind of a cool application that gets used quite often. So just some pointing out some of the reflective glass and the screens. And then other teleprompters, like on TV or news anchors use, the reflective glass is actually on the camera, and the words are displayed onto this reflective glass, but it's important to note that the words actually have to be displayed backwards, because once it interacts with the glass, the words are going to flip over. Once the words flip over, it's the correct way for the news anchor or TV star to read off the words. Other than teleprompters, you can use it at Disneyland. So Disneyland's Haunted House is a pretty famous example of Pepper's Ghost. So you and your family are riding on the Doom Buggy through the Haunted House, and you don't notice, but there's actually a glass pane that is next to you, and that's so that we can get our reflection at work to make that virtual image that I talked about. These animatronics, so these robots that are used for the eventual Pepper's Ghost, are actually above or below you, but the light shines on the objects and then reflects off the glass into an image. And we see these ghostly apparitions that are dancing on this picture to the left right here. That's another fun application. And then people use Pepper's Ghost actually in concerts, what we call digital doubles. What happens is you can actually, you know, bring celebrities back to life because you can just display a video of the celebrity in question, and then through reflection you can actually make them appear on stage. And they did that with Michael Jackson. He passed away, but in 2014 they brought back his digital double through Pepper's Ghost. I'm gonna play the video right here. With all that, I hope that from this you go about your everyday life, and if you see something like this, you'll say, oh, I know, that's the Pepper's Ghost effect, so thank you. And now I'm going to show the actual demo.
Yeah. So now that I've showed the diagram of how the Pepper's Ghost or pyramid works, this is how it works, you know, in real life. I have this plexiglass pyramid, as I described before, and as I said, on the smartphone, or in this case a television, there are these images of a jellyfish. The jellyfish actually travel up into the pyramid and then get reflected to the opposite surface. We need to note that there are four jellyfish here because there is one per surface.